So what did dinosaurs sound like? Well, welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. Now, when the makers of Jurassic Park were trying to come up with the sounds for dinosaurs, they mixed in horses, donkeys, swans, geese, turtles, and even a baby elephant to create the unique soundscape of the dinosaurs in the movie. Other documentaries tend to make the big carnivore dinosaurs roar like lions. The truth is that it's very difficult to recreate the sounds that these extinct creatures made, but there are some interesting clues for several dinosaurs which can help us reimagine the soundscape of the late Cretaceous world. All right, so first we can use the phylogenetic bracket model to listen to the living groups of dinosaur relatives. These are the living crocodilians and the living birds. So first, let's see, we'll listen to the deep guttural sounds of an alligator. All right, second we have the tweety sounds of birds. It's hard to imagine a distinct sound between these two extremes. Well, dinosaurs were a bit larger than a canary. Maybe they sounded like an ostrich scream. Or maybe it's an ostrich lower sort of guttural noises that it makes. Let's listen to that. So, since the soft tissue, the glottis, the larynx, the trachea, and the syrinx, which is how modern birds produce sounds, which is a voice box that's down at the bifurcation of the trachea, none of these structures are preserved in fossils. It's difficult to reconstruct the sounds of dinosaurs from the preserved anatomy of the skull and the bones. In fact, maybe dinosaurs crowed like a rooster, since they're more closely related to chickens than to lions. Now, one interesting dinosaur where we might be able to reconstruct the sound is a Lambdasaurian dinosaur called Parasaurolophus. It's one of the large ornithopod dinosaurs living in North America during the very late Cretaceous. Now, Parasaurolophus exhibited a large hollow-tubed crest. This hollow tube in Lambdasaurian dinosaurs was the nasal passage, which provided a long, convoluted path for breathing air in, but also by honking quickly by blowing air out through this passageway. This is similar to what instruments like the trumpets or trombones or French horns do to make different sounds. Thus, it's believed that these dinosaurs were able to honk, like brass instruments, very loudly through these convoluted nasal passages. Now, by scanning the skull, paleontologists are able to reconstruct the anatomy of these passageways. And they are able to take this and invent a dinosaur instrument to play the sounds that these dinosaurs made. Now, by passing air through a similar shaped instrument to the actual structure of the dinosaur skull, we might be able to reconstruct the sound that these ancient dinosaurs made. So here is the call of Parasaurolophus, a dinosaur that went extinct 66 million years ago. Let's listen. So you should now be able to demonstrate how the hollow nasal cavities of the Lambdasaurian dinosaurs allow researchers to reconstruct the song of these long extinct dinosaurs.